Scott Holewinski, and I am here to basically show a little bit about the sensitivity of hard drives. Something people don't realize is that on modern hard drives, everything is extremely important, right down to how tightly the screws are all screwed back on. So basically what I am going to do right now is take a healthy drive, show that it detects and it's healthy. I'm going to take the cover off and not pay any attention to the torque settings of the screws as I put them back in, and show that that simple act of taking the cover off, putting them back on, without paying attention to torque settings, is going to make the drive click. I'll then basically reset all the screws according to the right torque and show that the drive then detects once again. So I'll get started by just showing that this is a healthy drive. I'm just going to plug it in. A simple way of showing that is we'll just look for it in disk management here. So the drive is spinning up. It'll take a couple seconds to detect. And eventually it should show up here in our disk management as a healthy drive. There you go. It is an 80 gigabyte Western Digital drive, so it's perfectly healthy. I'm now going to actually power it down and simply just take the screws off, which is something very common. People are very curious about hard drives, especially when it starts doing some weird things. They oftentimes want to just pop the cover off and don't think anything of it. You know, what harm could it do? But without us actually having those original torque settings of the drive, sometimes it's very difficult for us to actually get it back into its original condition when we need to do recovery work on it. I'm just going to take all the screws out. The last screw that I take out is actually a screw that screws the head stack into the drive and actually keeps the actual read-write head secure. So this is a common thing. People just kind of check out what's going on inside the drive. From this point, we'll basically put the cover right back on. And again, I'm not going to pay any attention to the original torque settings of the drive. I'm just going to screw them back in. All right, so I've got the cover back on here, and what I'm going to now do is just power it back on, and unlike it sounded before, nice and healthy and detected over here, you're actually going to hear some pretty awful clicking noises coming from the device. The sound that you just heard was the clicking hard drive that you oftentimes hear referred to on the internet and everywhere else. And basically all it is the actual read-write heads in the drive. They're not in the correct position, and they're actually fluttering from side to side trying to figure out where the heck they are on the platter. So basically what I'm going to do next is actually torque the screws back down into the correct torque settings using a special torque driver here, which basically allows us to set the torque of the screws, and basically when I set each one, you'll actually hear a little click because it's actually set to the right torque setting. So all of the screws are now nice and snug. They're set to their factory specifications once again. I'm just going to basically power this drive up again, and unlike that awful clicking sound that you heard before, you're probably now going to see that the drive once again detects. So it made the good sound, it sounded happy. Basically we're just going to go into disk management here again, and there you go. There's our 80 gigabyte drive that once again showed up. So what you've just seen is an example of what can happen when you do something simple like take the cover off of a hard drive and simply put it back on. It seems very benign. It doesn't seem like it did a whole lot to the drive, but the torque settings on the screws are extremely important. And that goes for all the screws on a drive, not just the screws that are on the cover. All the internal screws that screw down the head stack are also very important to pay attention to the torque settings. Once again, we put the drive back to its original specifications, and as you just saw, it did detect.